So I would like to introduce our next speaker. That's Isaac Biarugaba, right? Yeah. Mr. Isaac Biarugaba. He holds a BSc in biotechnology, and under which he undertook his industrial training at NACRI. NACRI is a National Crops Research Institute in Namulonge at the Department of Biosciences. He also has a certificate in industrial biotechnology from University of Manchester, a certificate in basics of microbiology by WHO. He also has a certificate in entrepreneurship by Funzi Finland. And he actually also represented Uganda at a regional level during the Climate Launchpad 2021 edition. He has the charisma in the discovery and development of novel biotech product. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our next presenter. Thank you.
Yeah, hello everyone. I'm Isaac. On behalf of Geris, I'll be presenting us on how we can improve the standards of storage facilities as a way of enhancing food security and food safety. We are focusing on our preventative measures for the control of the aflatoxins production and accumulation among agricultural producers, whereby our focus crop is maize, which happens to be a staple food for billions of people across the globe. To begin with, in March this year, Kenya suspended the importation of maize from Uganda. This was because the maize was found to be contaminated by aflatoxins, and their levels had accumulated beyond safety measures. I also heard the president of Uganda during his State of Nation address, where he talked on how Uganda missed an opportunity for exporting maize to the Iranians because of the poor quality caused by shameful aflatoxins, as he stated it, that results from post-harvest handling. So, what are these aflatoxins? Yeah, just like the name states, these are toxins, they are harmful substances that are produced within cells of living organisms. These aflatoxins happen to be mycotoxins because they are synthesized by fungi. For these fungi to produce their aflatoxins, they are influenced by the moisture content of the agricultural produce, the grain damage. I credit to the farmers who are trying as much as they can to ensure that the moisture content is within the recommended range, that is 14% or and below, and who are also ensuring that this, before storing their produces, the grains that are damaged are eliminated. Another factor that influences the production of aflatoxins are the abiotic factors within the storage facilities, whereby the temperatures of 25 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius are the temperature ranges that favor the production of aflatoxins. During this temperature range, we are having high rate of respiration among the producers. And among the products of respiration, we have water vapor, water, which will increase the moisture content of the agricultural produce, thus completing the cycle, leading to the production of aflatoxins. Yeah, for those who may not know how these aflatoxins appear among the maize, on the extreme right and the extreme left, those are aflatoxins within maize, and in the middle, we are having an image of a grain that has the fungi that causes the aflatoxins. So, according to the Partnership for Aflatoxins Control in Africa, 25% of the food crops produced globally are contaminated by aflatoxins. On consumption of such food, and because these aflatoxins are known to be mutagenic, teratogenic, genotoxic, and carcinogenic under long-term exposure, health issues will have to arise. These conditions also apply to animals when the feeds are contaminated with aflatoxins. It so happens that temperature ranges within the most of the storage facilities within the tropics is the same temperature range that favors the production of aflatoxins. And so in presence of the fungi, we shall have aflatoxins produced and they will accumulate. This will have an effect on the quality and the quantity of the produces, which in the long run have an impact on the economy. Because these maize are, in an example of maize, they will not meet the standards for exportation. And you can imagine such a situation for that farmer who is selling the maize. And when these maize are not exported, where will they end? They will keep within the nation that is producing the maize, and these will end up in animals as feeds. And in the long run, we shall have health issues arising. Yeah, so by monitoring and controlling the temperature of storage facilities at temperatures lower than 25 degrees Celsius, we shall be reducing the rate of respiration within the agricultural produces. Thus, we shall be able to regulate and control aflatoxins accumulation. With the GALE solutions as a way of helping farmers monitor and control the temperatures within the storage facilities, even for the business people who are selling these agricultural produces, we are making a temperature sensor and a mobile application. This temperature sensor will be connected to the mobile application. The temperature sensor will be installed in the storage facility and connected to a fan. Through the mobile application, the temperature range will be set. In case of an increase in temperatures within the storage facility, a notification will be sent through the mobile application to the farmer or the person in charge of the store. And at the same time, a fan which is connected to the temperature sensor will turn itself on, increasing air saturation within the storage facility, thus reducing the temperatures. With us here, we have a product with us, which is connected there. We have a fan that is running, is connected power to us by power. And at the moment, it is controlled by a program that we having on the computer and sends an SMS to the farmer or to the person in charge of the store in case it is installed. Yeah, that we are seeing that black thing on top is a prototype for the fan that is rotating because it is powered on. And then the blue pit is a temperature sensor. And then that antenna-like thing is for the network, just to enable network for the SMS to be sent to the farmer through the mobile application. Back to the presentation. Yeah, so the way forward. Having completed the development of our product, that is the mobile application, which we are left with a few things to the completion, I will look forward to evaluate to what extent our product will be preventing aflatoxin production and accumulation in agricultural produces. This will be through determining the aflatoxins within the agricultural samples, then we store them, we put them in storage facility. Through the mobile application and the temperature sensor, we monitor the temperatures for a given period of time. Then after that period of time, we again test for the aflatoxins to determine whether there is a control. We have control in the production of aflatoxins, or we are controlling the accumulation, and also having an assurance for which temperatures are leading to the control of the aflatoxins. And then we are also looking forward to adding premium features to have a premium product. For example, this temperature sensor is powered by electricity. We are considering that rural farmer who may not be having electricity, looking forward to develop a temperature sensor that can be powered by solar energy. And also looking towards adding premium features, other premium features like a hub through which the farmers can interact, sharing about the temperature, how the product is operating. They can share through the same app, they can share like the different prices of the agricultural produce to increase the supply of the agricultural producers. Yeah, and then we're also looking towards developing an AI that can be used to detect the amount of aflatoxins present in the agricultural produces. Yeah, briefly about GALES, this is a venture which just started a few months ago during a fellowship, that is the Canada Africa Innovation Fellowship. Five fellows from Uganda were grouped with fellows from Canada to come up with a project idea in line with the SDGs of the United Nations. We draw an inspiration from the SDG number 2, which focuses on ending hunger through enabling food security. Yeah, I would like to acknowledge my other fellows, that is Gladys Obocha, whom I'm with here, Elliot Buzz, who is doing software engineering from Canada, and also we have Raki Patel on the team, who's doing mechanical engineering at the same time with a background in business administration. Yeah, thank you all.